Well, yeah. Guten Morgen, Damen und Herren. Wie geht es Ihnen? ich spreche keine Deutsch. Thank you. Well, now I'm speaking as the capacity of the Indonesian National Fish and Safety Committee. Well, I'm very aware that although that the infection control, especially hospital infection, hospital acquired infection control is very crucial and central to the patient safety. But please, in the session, I will share to you the broad spectrum of the patient safety in Indonesia, so you have a broad view on what is happening in Indonesia about the patient safety. Well, I'm presenting the map of Indonesia just to show the huge burden of Indonesia. If you know, maybe Indonesia is maybe as large as Europe. Okay, so the challenges in patient safety in Indonesia is the first is magnitude of that this the huge number of population, isolated widespread areas, and cultural diversity and beliefs, and also we have facing the limited infrastructures and awareness to the patient safety. Well, so our discussion today will include the first national leadership on patient safety, compliance to the global and regional studies on patient safety, infection control program in Indonesia, and our current principle in patient safety for the future. Well, actually, the patient safety began since 2005, and then it was inaugurated firstly by the Ministry of Health of Indonesia, and then after that, the Indonesian Hospital Association, who were initiated this meeting, and then they are also making a lot of activities, like a workshop regional, both nationally and also internationally. Well, and one of our achievement is that we have also pronounced the Jakarta Declaration for Southeast Asia region, that is hosted by the Indonesian Hospital Association on 2007. So, and also in 2012, the Indonesian Association of Anesthesiologists also adopted the Helsinki Declaration. No. Sorry. Well, so for the national policy on patient safety, we are not perfect yet. What we have a patient safety committee at the national level, but what we don't have is the integration of scattered activities. There are a lot of patient safety activities conducted by various institutions like Gajah Mada University and Sarjito Hospital is for an example. Well, so our action plan is how to formulate the integrated national policy on quality and patient safety, so we can move together. There is no question about the regulatory framework for patient safety. We have at least three acts to enforce the patient safety: Hospital Act, Health Act, and also Medical Practice Act, particularly for the practitioners. And also, we have the Ministry of Health decree on the patient safety regarding the patient safety activities, and also we have the decree for the Committee of the Patient Safety. So we have all of the regulatory framework. This is at least the figure of the patient safety committee profile, where I'm appointed as a chairman, and there are several persons. Well, so the competence standard for medical practice in Indonesia, so we are also concerned about patient safety in medical education. So that the Indonesian Medical Council also require every doctor have the core competence, that is to perform clinical procedures related to the health problem and applying patient safety principle that is required for every medical practitioner in Indonesia. Our strategy will conduct it in macro level, meso level, and also micro level. At the macro level, we are building the national capacity through the rules and regulation and advocating body. At the meso level, we are building the capacity of the institutional hospitals and faculty of medicines, and also we encourage them to have such policies and procedures regarding the patient safety, also access how to get access to health to resources. And at the micro level, we will encourage every professional to have this workshop and training in the patient safety. Well, so how do we implement this at the macro level? We are regulating about patient safety, and also we are accrediting every hospitals for that. And our focus activities are professional environment, regulation, and also monitoring and evaluation for the patient safety activities. Well, the second is we will share that our activities is comply to the global and regional strategies on patient safety, both at the WHO, WHO, or even the European community. Our official national reference that is adopted by the Ministry of Health, Ministry of Education and Culture, and also for another institution that we are adopting the WHO standard for that. Also, hospital accreditation committee also using the GCI for hospital, which a lot of patient safety measurements. Well, for the regional level, at about 1 or 2 months ago, we are attending and we are signing the agreement with the WHO CRO from the Southeast Asian countries. We have at least 6 strategic objectives, and we will comply to that. So, in terms of this strategic objective, we have some effort to accreditation mechanism for hospitals, laboratory, and diagnosis facilities. What we have done is that we have a national accrediting existed since 25 years ago, and we are adopting the GCI. But what we don't have is that we don't have the health inspectorate for quality, special for quality in the Ministry of Health. It's not just established. And the action plan is that the accreditation system will be improved with the involvement of the stakeholders and also the health inspectorate for quality in the Ministry of Health would be a good idea. And how to ensure the competent and capable workforce, which are aware to sensitive to patient safety, that what we have in place is that the implementation of curriculum of patient safety for 18 medical faculty, and it was implemented since 2011. It is according to WHO standard. What we don't have is that the curriculum for patient safety for other healthcare professionals, like nurses or other professionals. And how do we integrate the education curriculum and also with the other national patient safety strategy? So our action plan is developing curriculum for patient safety for other health professional workers. Well, this is an example. This is what we have done. We have creating the integration of patient safety in the medical education curriculum. It is funded by the Ministry of Education and Culture, and it has been implemented to 11 School of Medicine. So at least in the next 6 years, it's not too difficult for us to talk about patient safety. Well, I'm not sure whether I still have a time. Yeah, thank you. Well, okay. Now, there are several issues that what we have and what we still don't have. Well, safe surgical care, at for instance, that we have a national policy on safe surgical care, safe childbirth, safe injection. That's the policy. But, and what we have also the implementation of surgical checklist on some tertiary healthcare facilities. But what we don't have is the implementation of surgical checklist at all level of healthcare facilities and its consistency. So the action plan is how to improve and disseminate the surgical checklist. Well, how we see the patient safety in the hospital is like this. Well, if there is a medical adverse event, it could be it be caused by the medical procedures because the doctors have some clinical privilege on that. Well, so what is our strategy to overcome these issues is how do we control the behavior of the physician, particularly the specialist? Maybe they are not difficult to manage, but they cannot be managed or regulated. Well, so the patient safety is one of the issue is the risk of the adverse event, and also it could be resulted from the incompetence of the doctors and their behavior. So how do we control that with the medical council? We are controlling their registration. And also, in the hospital, we are developing the clinical governance. So next, we are relating all of this, and how do we relate all of the medical committee in the hospitals to the Indonesian Medical Council, so we can control all of the physician or medical practitioners in the hospitals at least. We have already in place the regulation for that, so we have no doubt about that. Why do we believe that? This is because patient safety comes from the safety culture, corporate culture, and it comes from the clinical, both clinical and corporate leadership. So we are aware that in this way, we are managing the patient safety. So the good clinical governance in hospital will encourage the patient safety. So at least, could you please, something happened. Oops, you start again. So we are planning to implement the ministerial decree on how to relate between Indonesian Medical Council and the medical committee in the hospital to risk professionalism. Well, so what about the infection control program in Indonesia? May I share with you the milestone and what is our achievement? At least the infection control program in Indonesia began since 2002, and then there are several activities up to now, but we are not perfect yet. Now we have a national working group, and also we appoint 10 hospitals as a model of ICP, including the Sarjito Hospital. So what is the achievement that I get from the Ministry of Health? That the achievement is that the dissemination of information regarding the ICP to 733 hospitals, 95 ICP trainers for 70 hospitals, which was trained to 72 hospitals, and we are also hosting an APEC meeting on 2013. And lastly, so what is our key principle in patient safety after 9 years of a journey? I want to share to you, with you, what do we now believe? First, we believe that that the patient safety could be improved by the openness of the health provider and how to modify the cultural behavior. Okay, sorry. Well, so what will be implemented to the national guidelines for the patient safety? For your information, we are now developing guidelines for patient safety. First, about the general principle of patient safety, and second, we are developing the incident report, national incident report guidelines, and the third is the root cause analysis and FMEA guidelines. Sorry. So all of that will be based on the situation awareness principle, where every healthcare professional, healthcare workers should aware of the situation and their circumstances. First, yourself. Secondly, know, be aware of your equipment and be aware of your team and your environment. I think this is also could be implemented in the infection control. And how can we protect ourselves from the error is that is from the situation awareness, that the human error will be sourced from the systems factors and also from the individual factors. So, because the situation awareness is very crucial, and then it will impact the clinical decision making for the physician or other healthcare professional. So we have three levels of medical errors. The first is the perception elements in the current situation. That is about how do we monitor, how do we know the signs maybe for the infections or other pathological signs. And secondly, how do we comprehend or interpret the the signs? And then thirdly is do we think about the future status, what shall we do about this? So we have three levels of errors on that. Well, so finally, this is our way of strategy of patient safety. Firstly, we have achieved the political commitment from everybody, and we have national support on patient safety. So we have already in place the regulatory framework, and from that we can allocate resources and technical support. So we will communicate this policy to everybody, including maybe to the House of Representatives and also the municipal government, and also this is the role of the Patient Safety Committee. We are developing also standards and guidelines, and also after that we can implement the need assessment and community self-survey. We are also can after that we can conduct the innovative action, and also including every stakeholders to develop the common action plan and joint evaluation. And this is at least the learning organization. How do we achieve this cycle for the patient safety? Well, the conclusion is that although patient safety activities were not new in Indonesia, we are not perfect yet. We are still struggling to challenge the huge obstacle to comply with the global standard on patient safety. Thank you for your attention.